Hand me the mic.
Sheriff Levin speaking. Get out an All Points bulletin. Those Johnson City bank robbers broke through our roadblocks. They're headed west in a black sedan. Take it easy. They're armed and dangerous. Take no chances.
Ghost town, all right.
And made to order for us.
Listen, Rocky, if you're thinking of hiding out in this junk heap, you're
out of speed. The loot. What could be better? Nobody's lived here for 50 years. Nobody'll think of looking here. This is a real ghost town. Not even on a tourist trail. Tree Hotel. Good a place as any.
You're nuts. Why stash the money here? We can be in the city in 3 hours.
Speed, I told you. Leave the thinking to me. So we hide the stuff here for a few weeks till things cool off.
Yeah, that figures.
We can switch cars, clear out, and then when the cops get tired of looking, we come back for it.
I'm with you, boss.
Let's look inside.
Don't sit down. Now, look here, Jackie. When you signed up to be my partner, I agreed to grubstake you. But I can't tote my 30-day supply of vittles in your too. Besides, you got no call to get cantankerous with me. Didn't I treat you to 2 root beers and an ice cream cone at Indian Joe's? Now, you just tote that feed back into Langtree. Or I'll cut it loose, and you'll have to live on sagebrush and cactus for the next 30 days. Now, come on.
I hope it's still there when we come back.
What are you worrying about? We'll have the best watchman in the world.
Ghosts.
Son, glad to see you. Howdy, Frankie.
Hi. Find Ranch Randall's hidden treasure yet?
No, not yet. I've been too busy lately to hunt for it.
Well, howdy, Jim.
Hi, Wendy.
Hiya, Pete.
Hi.
Well, what's been keeping you so busy?
Well, you know how it is. Being mayor and chief of police, fire chief, and magistrate of a town like this, it kind of runs you down.
I can imagine. Well, we've been out looking for some strays that wandered over to this side of the valley, so we brought you some newspapers and magazines.
And here's a couple of quarts of fresh milk for you.
Well, say, now, that's right neighborly of you fellas. Yes, indeed. You know, this here paper I got is nigh on to a month old. I just got to reading about them bank robbers over Johnson City. Did they catch up with them yet?
No, according to the paper this morning, they haven't found any trace of the men or the $65,000.
Now, if an I was marshal in Johnson City, I'd have had those hombres before they'd got 10 paces.
Were you ever town marshal, Wendy?
Why, sure. When I wasn't too busy fighting Indians or riding Pony Express.
Pony Express? Gee, I'll bet that was something. And dangerous, too, wasn't it, Wendy?
Well, it sure was. Well, once I had a ride through Comanche and Paiute country with an arrow right in my shoulder here.
That must have slowed you down.
Can a measly old Indian arrow slow down grease lightning? Well, sir, about 2 weeks later, I was riding west when I saw a party of 20 braves. Whoa, I says to my pony. I took a good look, and I saw they were getting ready to ambush old General Bradford in the 13th Cavalry. Well, sir, I dismounted, and I started a snake crawl. And right through them Apaches I went, arrows flying all around me. And there I was, smack dab in the middle of a war party shooting arrows all around me. And I jumped up and I let out my own special war cry. Whoop! Whoop!
Shut The war chief right through the bonnet, hog-tied that medicine man, and then surrounded all the rest of them Apaches.
How'd you know about that?
Well, I ought to know it. You've been bending my ear with it for 15 years.
All right, kid. Let's go find those strays, huh?
Gosh, Jim. Can't Frankie and me stay with Wendy a little longer? And then for the buried treasure some more? Please?
Well, all right. We'll come back for you.
Thanks, Jim.
See you later, Wendy.
So long, Jim.
Oh, Wendy's told them stories so often he believes them himself.
He likes to live in the past, doesn't he?
Yeah, right now he's got half the county believing he built the old Langtree. I remember when he first showed up here. This here was already a ghost town.
Yeah, maybe he did live here in the old days when he was a young man.
Them stories of his. I remember a yarn he told me once about lifting some Comanche scalps wild enough to make the hair raise up on my head. You reckon any of them things he tells ever happened?
What's the difference? Look at the fun those kids are having hunting for that treasure. Yeah, he's got a knack for keeping them happy. That's what counts.
Let's go treasure hunting, Frankie. Okay. See you later, Wendy.
Sure. I'll be here. Go ahead. It's about time for me and Jackie to catch a siesta anyhow.
Where we look first?
Oh, we've looked most every place already.
We never tried any of the buildings on this side of the street.
Powerful, tiring job. Run the whole town to yourself.
Hey, how about this old hotel?
Why'd anybody hide money in a hotel?
Because nobody think of looking for it there, maybe.
Awful dark.
Here. Pull this. There, now we can see. Come on.
Oh, there's nothing but junk down here.
I wonder what's in that trunk.
What is it?
A whole bag full of it. We found it under the hotel. The shelf came down, and we stuck our hands in it, and golly!
Whoa, now, one at a time. What you got here?
Rance Randall's treasure.
What's in it? Gold? Silver?
Money. Whole stacks of it.
Yeah, there's a good heft to it. You know, the Abilene Kid come to town one time looking for this here sack. But I ran him out of Langtree before he got to fire more than 5 shots. Yes, sir? He even tried to dry gulch me, and holy jumping horned toads. It is money.
That's what we've been trying to tell you, Wendy.
That's a real stack of greenbacks, all right. Johnson National Bank.
Now you can fix up the town like it was in the old days.
Sure. Rance Randall's treasure is yours now, Wendy.
Now, wait a minute, boys. This ain't Rance's treasure. This money is from that bank robbery.
But how did he get here?
Oh, there's no telling. But it ain't ours to monkey around with, I'll tell you that. When I was a young wild one, I might have been tempted. But now, as marshal, mayor, and magistrate of this town, I've got to uphold the law.
Sure, Wendy.
You know where that emergency phone box is out on the desert road?
Yeah, about 2 miles.
Well, you just hightail it out there and get the sheriff on the wire, you see? And tell him to rush his hide over here and get this swag before the fellas that hit it
come a snooping around for it.
Come on, Frankie. We got to run.
There.
Took you so long?
I got here as fast as I could. What's the pitch?
65 G's. I figure it's been laying in that ghost town long enough to cool off.
You think the heat's off?
Look, I didn't ask you to meet Ox or me out here because I like fresh air. Come on, let's go get our dough.
Now, wait a minute, Joey. Let me get this straight. You say that old Windy read about the bank robbery a couple of hours ago? In a month-old newspaper. And you found the money about a half an hour ago? Yeah. Yeah. Well, you tell old Windy to just hold tight. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take care of it. All right, Joey. Goodbye. Oh, that Windy. What's he gonna think of next?
What's he up to now?
Now he's got Joey Newton believing that he's found that loot from the Johnson National Bank.
No.
You know, Jackie, if just being alone with this much money can worry me like it do, imagine how terrible it'd be to have millions to worry about. You'll be quiet. Not a word out of you. It's just like I feared.
It's them bandits. Come back for the swag.
I'm gonna see what they're up to.
Beat us to it.
Someone, huh?
What do you mean?
There's only us three who knew about the dough. Ox isn't smart enough to pull a double cross.
Would I be dumb enough to come back here with you guys if I took the money?
Yeah, I guess you're right. Hey, this could be a trap. The cops could be hidden all over this place just waiting for us to come back after the dough. I'd like to take this place apart piece by piece.
I'll do it for you, boss.
Hey, quit it. You'll have the building down on us.
Let's get out of here.
Now, Jack, we gotta keep them bandits here until the sheriff gets here.
What's that?
A ghost, maybe?
That you meathead was a donkey. And it came from that stable. These kids look too smart to make trouble. So you told the sheriff, huh?
Yeah, on emergency phone. You'll be sorry. He said he's coming right out. Keep quiet, Frankie. These the bank robbers.
You're too late, kid. I know all I need. The sheriff can't get here under 2 hours. That ought to give us plenty of time. Now, wise guy, who's this Windy? And where is he? He's hiding somewhere around here with the money sack, ain't he?
I don't know.
Look, smarty pants, I never roughed up a kid. But for 65 grand, I could be tempted. Now, where's this Windy character?
Somebody calling me?
Okay, Grandpa, where's the dough?
Appears like you're looking for something I'm supposed to know about.
You know, all right, and so do the kids. And stop talking if you don't want to see your young friends hurt. Well?
All right.
Stay with him. Keep him out of sight. Let's go.
Hey,
where you going?
It's downstairs in the hotel storeroom.
It's not an air. We looked.
Expect you did, but not in the right place.
Well, where is it? Where is it?
Inside, in the bottom of that trunk.
Flash the light over here. Up speed.
Hey, kid, get on your horses and get out of here fast.
Look at Pete and Jim.
All right, you kids.
That's far enough. All right, come on back here.
He must have gone down there.
I need your help.
Come here. Come here.
All right, go around that way. Just don't move now, mind you. Stand right there. Get right back on it. Stay there now. Stand right there. Don't move.
Look, Winnie, we got them all hogtied.
Danged if this ain't like the old time. I got them other two holed up in there with Jackie holding the fort. All right, get on your feet, you. Come on, up. Come on here.
Let me do it, boss.
Shut your face.
Sure, boss.
Howdy, Fury.
Looks like one of Wendy's tall tales done come true.
Lead the way.
Trussed up, like you see, and there's two of them down there in the hole.
Well, who are they?
The Johnson bank robbers.
What?
And here's the $65,000.
Looks like they made the mistake of tangling with the Marshal of Langtree and his deputies, huh?
To visit me again.
You brought your papers. Got a story in it about you and Langtree.
Here you are.
Oh, thanks, Pete.
Hey, a couple more stories like that, Wendy, and you'll have tourists flocking in here by the hundreds.
Tourists? People? Langtree's a ghost town. We don't want folks traipsing up and down.
Well, I thought you always wanted to put Langtree back on the map.
Ain't never been off the map. You just ought to see the big old Wells Fargo map still hanging on the wall of that corner building.
We never saw that, Wendy.
Didn't you, Joey? Well, come on. I'll show it to you and Frankie. Come on.
Bet he tells him he made that map.
And danged if I don't want to hear that story myself.